will receive your light. You give me faith like a child. In you my heart runs wild. My heart is open wide. I will receive. What's on your heart, what's on your mind, oh, and I want to get lost in your thoughts, oh, I want to get lost in your thoughts, I want to get lost in your thoughts, oh, God, I want to get lost in your it's just you and me, just you and me.
Kind of love.
into the holy place. You made a way for me to enter the holy place. You made a way for me to enter. enter the holy place. You made a way for me to enter the holy place. Oh, you made a way for me to enter the
We're now going into a time of prayer and praying and singing from the Word of God. Tonight we'll be reading from Isaiah 60, 10 through 22. I encourage you to find it in your Bible and join us as we meditate, sing, and pray through Isaiah 60, verses 10 through 22. Isaiah 60, verse 10. Foreigners shall build up your walls, and their kings shall minister to you. For in my wrath I struck you, but in my favor I have had mercy on you. Thank you, God, that you extend mercy and grace and restoration that brings us out of our own destruction. We confess our need for your provision, for you provide from the overflow and through delivery systems that we would never guess. Our protection and strength come from you, from your provision, from others who shore us up, bound together with others in various and foreign ways. God, you've made us to need others, to be dependent on you and the provision that you bring. It's in the hands of those that we may not trust easily unless you sent them. Thank you, God, that you send through foreign ways everything that we need.
You who sent them, answer to me. I put my trust in you. I put my trust in you. I put my trust in you. Oh, the good God, the only good God. And I'll admit that I've been doubtful. And I'll admit that I've been skeptical. How will you use this? How will you use that? But I choose to put my trust in you and your ways, for only you know. Only you know how I'm best built up. How I'm best built up.
Chapter 60, verses 11 through 13. Your gates shall be open continually, day and night they shall not be shut, that people may bring to you the wealth of the nations, with their kings led in procession. For the nation and kingdom that will not serve you shall perish. Those nations shall be utterly laid waste. The glory of Lebanon shall come to you, the cypress, the plane, the pine, to beautify the place of my sanctuary, and I will make the place of my feet glorious. God, for your glory you bless us with the wealth of nations. You shower blessings on us from every side. Teach us what it means to keep our gates open, to allow your protection to be enough, You have your plans for those who choose to stand against us. Every enemy is laid low by your strength. You are the watchman over my gates, so I won't shut out any that you desire to enter. You bring blessing, grace, abundance through my gates when I look to you and you alone. When I put my trust in my gates, the only way I can be protected is when they are shut. But you call for open gates that the wealth and blessing can pour in. So I will trust you to keep guard over my gate and swing the gates wide open. Teach my heart to trust you and your goodness. When I fully trust in you, I will never be put to shame.
to you, the glory of the Lord shall come to you, the glory of the Lord shall come to you, the glory of the Lord shall come to you, the glory of the Lord shall come to you. The glory of the Lord shall come to you. The glory of the Lord shall come to you. The glory of the Lord shall come to you. The glory of the Lord shall come to you. So let shine, let His glory shine, the glory of the Lord shall come to you, shall come to you. Keep your gates open, keep your gates open, and trust in Him. Keep your gates open, keep your gates open, and trust in the One who protects, in the One who provides for you. Bring in the wealth of the nations. He will bring you glory, and He will keep out what's meant to be kept out. Trust in the Lord, trust in.
Isaiah chapter 60, verses 14 through 16. The sons of those who afflicted you shall come bending low to you, and all who despised you shall bow down at your feet. They shall call you the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Whereas you have been forsaken and hated with no one passing through, I will make you majestic forever, a joy from age to age. You shall suck the milk of nations. You shall nurse at the breast of kings. And you shall know that I, the Lord, am your Savior and your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. Lord, you in time always reveal the identities that we have for what they are. You bring us into victory supernaturally when reality shows that we're the underdog, and you bring the high and mighty low and show us for who we are. You have called us your own. You have made us heirs to a kingdom that towers over all others. Though for a time we may be called many untrue names, forsaken, forgotten, and lonely, you have made us full sons with a powerful and majestic identity. Teach us to live in the confidence of the identity that you have put on us. For your glory, you show your might by bringing the best of all to the feet of your heirs in the kingdom. You have redeemed us, not for a limited survival, but as a glorious showcase of your might. We will freely receive the blessings that you desire to fill us with.
Where once I was called, forsaken, where once I was called forsaken. Revealing the truth to I can trust and believe. Truth has made its way here. Truth has made its way here. Jesus has made his way here to my heart, into my heart, into my heart with his truth, into my heart. So I'm shaking off those lies. Shaking off those lies, watching them fly away like dust. What felt so heavy? What felt so heavy once? Now it's just dust. As I put on my royal garments, as I put on my royal garments. I'm a child of God. I'm a child of the King. I'm a child of the King.
Jacob,
sound coming on the wind, changing hearts and minds, healing brokenness. I feel a generation breaking through despair. I hear a generation full of faith declare, and our song it will be out of the darkness we will rise and sing. He is faithful, he is glorious, and he is Jesus, and all my hope is in him. He is freedom, he is healing right now, he is hope and joy, love and peace and life. I have seen a light like the break of dawn, giving blind men sight, letting lame men walk. I see a generation with resurrection life. We are a generation filled with the power of Christ, and our song it will be out of the darkness we will rise and sing. He is faithful, he is glorious, and he is Jesus, and all my hope is in him. He is freedom, he is healing right now, he is hope and joy and love and peace and life. He is faithful, he is glorious, and he is Jesus, and all my hope is in him. He is freedom, he is healing right now, he is hope and joy and love and peace and life. And he has paid the highest price, he has proven his great love for us. We will praise him with our lives and proclaim our love for him. He has paid the highest price, he has proven his great love for us. We will praise him with our lives and proclaim our love for him, and proclaim our love for him. He is faithful, he is glorious, and he is Jesus, and all my hope is in him. He is freedom, and he is healing right now, he is hope and joy and love and peace and life. He is faithful, he is glorious, and he is Jesus, and all my hope is in him. He is freedom, and he is healing right now, he is hope and joy and love and peace and life. 'Cause he has paid the highest price, he has proven his great love for us, and we will praise him with our lives has paid the highest price. He has proven his great love for us. We will praise him with our life and proclaim our love for him. And proclaim our love for him. Joy and love and peace and light. He is light. He is light. Jesus. He is light. He is
Jesus. We will now continue in a time of praying and singing through the Word of God from Isaiah 60. Isaiah 60, verse 17. Instead of bronze, I will bring gold, and instead of iron, I will bring silver. Instead of wood, bronze. Instead of stones, iron. I will make your overseers peace, and your taskmasters righteousness. Lord, we underestimate the richness of your desires for us. You never give second-rate gifts. You are worthy of all glory, and we, in your name, are to receive your best blessings, to shine forth for you. Teach us to see the gold and silver that you deliver through our gates. What we have, we make an offering to you, for you are worthy of it all. You have given an overseer and a taskmaster for us to labor under, but these are not hard masters, for we are servants of peace and righteousness. Obedience to these is in our best interest and is well for the kingdom of heaven. Lord, realign our hearts and minds when we see your riches as a burden and your rule as restrictive. Our true liberty is found in servanthood to your peace and your righteousness. The greatest depth of riches is finding ourselves at the bottom of the heap of your overflowing storehouses. Teach us your ways, God.
Teach me your way, oh God. Oh, let me see what you're doing.
'Cause your way is reach for me. Your way is best for me. Oh, teach me, oh God, of your way.
Show me what you can peace never lets up, never lets go.
Isaiah 60, verses 18 to 20. Violence shall no more be heard in your land, devastation or destruction within your borders. You shall call your walls salvation, and your gates praise. The sun shall be no more your light by day, nor for brightness shall the moon give you light, but the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun shall no more go down, nor your moon withdraw itself, for the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended. God, not only in riches and ruling, you turn our upside down ways of seeing everything right side up. Also, our walls are called salvation, and this is the only shield we need. Our gates will be wide open and guarded by you as we sing your praise. You are our source of light and life. When we look to you for our light, we will never be disappointed. We lay down our right to protect, to guide, to power, to provide for ourselves. It is all you, and our trust is complete only in you.
You turn everything right side up. You turn everything right side up. You turn everything right side up. In my world, in the world, everything right side up. My defender, the defender of my peace. Where there was once destruction and violence, now you've called my wall salvation, and now you call my gates praise. You call my wall salvation, and you call my gates praise. You turn everything right side up. You turn everything right side up.
And
Isaiah 60, verses 21 to 22. Your people shall all be righteous. They shall possess the land forever, the branch of my planting, the work of my hands, that I might be glorified. The least one shall become a clan, and the smallest one a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will hasten it. God, all who are found in you are righteous, fully righteous through no work of our own, fully provided for, fully safe, fully known. You make us secure, not only for our good, but to bring full attention to your glory. In you, we find weaknesses strong as you use them. We find the least in us made great. You do all this in your time, in a moment, in a flash. We will glorify you and give you all praise to your worthy name as we see you take our little and make it much. Thank you that you are fully God, that everything you put in us is for your glory. We trust you. We accept it all. We turn it back to you for your glory. Teach us how to trust. Amen. Now we'll be going into a time of intercession through prayer topics. Tonight we'll be praying for Israel. Specifically, we'll be praying for a turning of hearts and minds toward truth. Please come into agreement with me as I pray along with the prayer points on the screen, and then raise intercession with your own voice as the Spirit leads you to pray through each topic. God, with the struggle to work out our own salvation, our hearts harden. Please do what only you can do and melt the hearts of stone into hearts of flesh again. Hearts that can feel the piercing of the double-edged sword of the Spirit and truth. This is what we pray. Send your refining fire to burn away all impurity. It It will not take months or years, for you can do it in a moment. Prepare your beloved, Israel, removing the scales from her eyes, blockage from her ears, and open her mouth to praise you alone. God, let the hardness that built up over generations of fighting for survival fall away in a moment of knowing your divine provision. Unclench the hands of the hurting. We declare over Israel tonight a release from the burden of hardening herself against oppression and aggression. We declare rest from the work of protecting what only you can protect. Lord, pour out your living water to soften hardened hearts. Let's pray. Would you send your mighty rushing wind of the Spirit across the nation of Israel? From border to border, we declare a fresh outpouring of your word and anointing of your people to know it as truth. Just as before, when the people of Israel renewed their devotion to your word as a nation After decades of neglect and disobedience, we prophesy a massive turning, returning to your word from simply hearing it anew and afresh. We declare your law is truth, your word brings life, and you've given it to man as a key to restoration from hopeless judgment. We declare that the stopped up ears and the blinded eyes, the hardened hearts of your people will be healed with just a word of truth from your law. Let's pray. Lord, use your people to reveal your truth. Raise up shepherds and prophets to stand tall in every area of society. Let education and entertainment, politics, and every area of society find prophets rising up to take their place and declare truth with confidence and love. We prophesy that as the words go out from these that you've chosen through television and podcasts every platform of social media that the hearts of those who hear and see the truth will melt in confession of the truth. We declare your message going out, not in anger, but in holy fear that brings repentance. Let humility lead to repentance, repentance to courage, and courage to renouncing wickedness as a people. We pray this not only for a few, but all across the nation of Israel. Raise up your prophets, God. Let's pray. King of kings and Lord of lords, you hold kings and rulers in the palm of your hand. we declare a fresh unction across the worldwide church to press in for the nation and the leaders of Israel. Pour out your heart for your chosen people into the intercessors around the globe. Move on the hearts of leaders and policies of nations to realign with Israel in protection and advocacy on the worldwide stage. Raise up presidents and prime ministers and kings to stand with Prime Minister Netanyahu to be a wall of protection and strength for the nation of Israel. We declare intercessors and friends and brothers rising up to envelop Prime Minister Netanyahu in an inner circle of strength and wisdom. We claim your blessing, God, the blessing you have promised, God of Israel, for those who stand with your people, the nation of Israel. We claim that blessing for every nation and every man and woman who stands with Israel in this time. Turn the hearts of your church and turn the hearts of the nations toward your people, Israel, God. Let's pray. I thank you that you are the God of Israel. You are their provider. You are their sun. You are their shield. You have chosen your people, and you dearly love them. God, we pray that as you reveal your word to them, that they would see not only a law that brings death, but an invitation to salvation. God, I pray that you would open the ears of those who have not heard, even though they've heard the words many, many times. I thank you, God, that you are bigger than anything the world says about your people, that you are stronger than any weakness, that they seem to show. We thank you, God, that all is in your control, that your kingdom invites your people in. We stand with you. We receive your blessing for standing with your people. Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen. Thanks for joining us this evening. I hope it was a good time digging into Isaiah 60. And we invite you to come back next Wednesday morning and Thursday evening. As usual, we have watches. But in addition to that, we are actually starting something new next Tuesday evening at 7:30. And this is, you're all welcome to come out to it. And it's something that we're calling K1 Cafe.